niggas ain't heard no shit like this. And
why you
get on up.
Wait a minute now.
Get on up.
Happy birthday, James Brown.
Happy birthday.
Yeah.
Shout out to Macon, Georgia right now.
And Augusta, GA.
Yo, it's Reach Around Radio. Challenge Thursday.
Shout out to the Camel Walk.
Challenge.
It's a Talent Thursday, boy.
It's a shower.
It's your boy Speedy in the house. Just want to let all the ladies know I love you, and I know you love me, and this is for you, baby.
Oh, my God. Really, Speedy? Get up.
Let it marinate
like Claudia's pot roast.
I'm sorry. It's definitely marinating.
She's killing you.
On top of that Kelly T.
You don't even know the song, huh?
This is, come on. This is
name?
Pedophile. I'm sorry, R.
Wow.
Off the album, I Hope You're Pedophiling Me.
God, Speedy, sing it.
Come
on, Speedy.
I think it's a genius.
That was good.
And inside of your walls, there will dwell a Capricorn.
Well, a couple of them.
You can't fuck with it. I love it. You niggas are stumped.
No. Let it ride. Let it ride. All
because I'm the greatest, baby. Of a
greatest you.
Oh. I got it. You're grazing in me too. grazing in the grass.
Hang your head on that one. I see you, boo, trying to get in. Don't get in on my shit.
Making a food song about him.
Hey, wait a minute. It's the pimpin' in me.
I think he made it about himself.
That will. Eat Cheetos off your toes. It's the greatest with me.
I got two stomachs, one for meat and one for vegetables, baby.
That wasn't
apple
funny.
Turnover.
That was not that funny.
Yeah.
Yo, it's your
I'm
boy.
Trying.
Don't interrupt the gas, Speedy.
It's your boy Speedy and I.
I'm the poetess. Claudia.
Teeter, Mr. Three Knox, baby.
And Barry Really White is in the building. What's up, y'all?
Special guest.
Your boy Boo Half Boo Capone having a ball,
up, Boo?
Man.
Hey, Boo, just, man. Can you give them all the names?
Yeah, Boo Capone, Boo Half, Boo Ferrigno, Boo Pac, Boo Belafonte. You dig? You understand?
So when you walk up to a bitch. What exactly do you say?
What's the acronym for bitch again?
Oh, beautiful, intelligent creature of heaven.
Oh,
BITCA. Some silent.
Intelligent.
But see, the thing, the end is silent. See, the thing is,
thank you.
The eye is silent.
The eye is silent, but the thing is, I was hollering at this bitch. The other day, she's talking about fucking. She seen that movie. Was it Think Like a Man? Act Like a Woman. Think Like a Man.
Yeah,
Steve
right.
Harvey. I said, "Think a bitch. You better act like a bitch and think like a hoe." But listen, and that's another thing. Steve Harvey. I have nothing against Steve Harvey, but the nigga been divorced what 4 times?
Mm.
He trying to tell some pimps he giving up all the drawings. That nigga head look like a knee. Have you seen his head? Nigga, oh, head. Quick, give it up to information, dog.
Think like a man and get a prenup.
Right. So we come up with more names like during the show. Is that okay? We suggest some more names.
For sure, we'll drop some more. Hey, Speed, hold on. That was that R. Kelly y'all was playing.
Yeah,
I love R. Kelly, man. I was watching the cold thing. I was watching Whitney Houston when he sung at the funeral. I was watching it, man. I got choked up. I really did, man, because he had me choked up. And then I was looking at the TV like, who is R. Kelly? The nigga was really into it. He was looking at this little 12-year-old bitch that was in the back. R. Kelly, man.
Okay.
I didn't know where he was going.
I'm just fucking around. R. Kelly, my dude. He had a hell of a party at Chuck E. Cheese. Don't know.
There you go. That's
that nigga had a pocket full of tokens. I love R. Kelly. It's jokes. It's just jokes.
But you got to get him yourself.
Let's play grab and go get it.
It's jokes. It's jokes. Yo.
Who we got now?
It's Talent Thursday.
Pocket full of tokens.
And,
prove it.
No, what is the song called again? What's the song?
I hope you're petty feeling me.
On Tuesday was May Day. You know that that's the workers' holiday. And so I went out to a rally at Southwest College, and I seen two poets there that I thought were outstanding, and I invited them on the show today. And the first poet in the house with us is Matt Cedillo, or Cedillo. Matt is a two-time National Slam poet and published author. Matt has been featured in the LA Times and has performed at universities across the country. And today he's at Reach Around Radio. Give it up for Matt Cedillo.
Matt!
Yeah. Welcome.
How you say your name, Matt?
Cedillo. I said Cedillo.
How you
feeling
today?
Feeling good. Cedillo.
Have you heard the show before?
I've heard of it. I had not actually
it's
heard
okay
it.
It's okay if you haven't heard it. It's okay.
No. Quite all right.
Okay, go ahead. Sometimes, but welcome to the show.
Thank you. All right, so I'm just going to get right into this. It's dedicated to LA's finest. It's called LA's Full Pigs. Los Angeles falling apart. In the streets. In the suburbs. In the wind. In a barely kept Hollywood bathroom, wheezing, vomiting, coughing up blood. These past few days, these past few years, I've spread myself across this sprawl. And now fear the strife may kill me. Kill us all. And I wander. Over to General Hospital, between whose walls desperation wears in high concentration. Upon the faces of the shopworn and prematurely ill alike. As they wait upon the news of illness they cannot afford to have. Survival without insurance. This may take a while. Los Angeles is full of untold misery. A homeless man sleeps next to me, and I can smell the years of hard distance between who he is now and who he may have been. And all that stands between him and the bitter wind is chance, is the kindness of a night nurse who will let him sleep in peace. Los Angeles is full of good people who from time to time can turn a blind eye to killer policy, and I wonder how more bounce checks, free clinics, carry cash, and leave the count in the negative stands between me and him. Me and the bitter wind, and if so, where would I go? From Venice to San Francisco, there's not a war on the homeless, a war on the dispossessed. There are fewer and fewer options. They got shelters for women and children, all in Agra. For me, just man up, homeboy, to that concrete pillow, to that cardboard blanket, and freeze your ass to death. Yes, this city will leave to die on the same stretch of sidewalk where banks stretch into the sky. And I wonder, as even now Skid Row is being gentrified, as this city, as this system, as the pigs push people past poverty, past hunger, past homelessness to the very edge of existence on Skid Row, where all so-called complexities of an economy are laid bare, where the rich are literally stacked upon the poor. Los Angeles is full of grotesque absurdity, especially on Skid Row, where they spend millions annually policing the misery of people with nowhere to go, because when your pockets are empty and you ain't got nothing and change is just not coming, when there is no real difference between a booming metropolis and a barren desert, and the world of money passes by you, passes through you, as though you were just part of the scenery protected in the knowledge they are serviced by pigs who speak the language of violence, the language of the nightstick, the language of untold misery that will beat you for begging, beat you for sleeping, beat you for breathing, beat you for doing whatever it is you need to do to survive the night in the bitter wind. Los Angeles. I said fucking Los Angeles. It's full of motherfucking pigs.
All right.
Hell of a
lung capacity. That nigga look like the nigga that hit that cop in the back of the head with the skateboard.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. Damn, he beat it with that drum.
With that drum, hell yeah.
You're not a weed smoker, right? You're not a weed smoker, right? Your lung capacity is amazing.
Yeah. Thank you, Matt. Where can people get your poetry? You have a book here, Matt Cedillo, For What I Might Do Tomorrow.
Right, For What I Might Do Tomorrow. I'm going to... I don't carry them to many bookstores these days, so I always get messed over on that process, because bookstores' first priority is to pay themselves and to pay the light bill. And
well, do you have a website, or where can people get it?
You can go to PayPal. My email is mattcedillo1981@gmail.com.
Okay.
And you can order it that way. It's $18 plus shipping handling.
Cedillo, Cedillo.
Cedillo. And
support him for sure, man.
Yeah, for sure.
Facebook
for
sure.
page. That was very compelling.
Facebook, just type in my name. You'll find me. I'm the one with a couple thousand.
Matt, you're very strong. How many times have you been arrested?
I know.
I've been pretty, you know, only on DUIs, but I've been pretty smooth about getting away.
The slicker in my system right now is making me get arrested.
I am out of Patron. This is a bullshit. I need some more alcohol.
No. I performed that once at Art Walk, actually, and I was so drunk, I forgot, like, the words. I knocked the microphone over, and I picked it up, and I'm like, you know what point is? LA's full of pigs. That piggy came to Art Walk. I threw the mic down and ran away.
Keep coming back, man.
That was excellent. You made me feel poor listening to it.
I really appreciate that. If you need my sponsor's number, I'll give it to you. Keep coming back. It works.
You're very passionate. Very passionate.
Thank you, everyone. Good. Give it up for Matt
Cecilio.
Coming up, we're going to keep it going. The next poet we have, he was also at the event on Tuesday. Okay. And he goes by Darnell, a.k.a. Mr. Poetic. Yeah. Darnell is a spoken word artist who has appeared on KJLH national slam teams. He has also spoke at schools such as UCLA, USC, LMU. Now he is here to perform on Reach Around Radio.
Like
give
that
it up
shirt.
For Mr. Poetic.
You know what's up, man. Hey. This is just a free right to try to capture my thoughts. They've been flying around space for way too long. I've been holding back for way too long, but now it's time to lace my chucks up. I'm forgetting about all the fuck ups because they don't matter when you're on top. I smoke weed and I'm not going to stop asking. No need for harassing something you would never understand. And for the record, my brain cells do not die. They expand. One puff and I take off into a land where I can free my mind to move mountains with metaphors. I'm doing the same thing I do every day, Pinky. Trying to take over the world one line at a time. God sent the message through me to reach one mind at a time. And every day that goes by gets closer to me running out of time. So excuse me if I don't conform to your set of rules. Excuse me if I come off a little rude. When I tell you to move, I'm heading out of the atmosphere. While you're still standing there, wondering how did I get there? How about focusing on yourself? When did you forget to be yourself? Smoking is bad for your health, but so is ignorance. You're just an experiment if you don't have a mind of your own. A perfect clone of what's supposed to be American. I am a black American, but what is that? Black is a color. I am a person. Acknowledge me. Start acknowledging that there's nothing wrong with the economy. There's something wrong with the people that control it. Global warming is real. Grabs a family that's buried under a broken foundation in Haiti. Stop all of the hating. You have a death awaiting. So live your life and put a smile on your face. I figured out that there's no more time to waste, so it's time to pick up the pace. This is a stick up. I'm demanding your respect. You can't full court press a full court threat. I've been drop body bombs. I'm a world war vet. What more do you expect? I'm aiming at success. When my haters are watching, that's when I'm on my best. Wake up. This is a test. This is a test. This is a test. This is a public service announcement to inform you that the revolution will not be televised. It will be on your front lawns. Grab your pens and be prepared to drop lyrical bombs. Ring the alarms as a madman on the loose. And screaming a revolution for American troops who come home and hang themselves with American flags as their noose. Pay attention to the truth. The stock of your lives is rising through the roof. This is just history remixed and relooped by Soulja Boy.
Oh, dang. You better stop hollering at me. I know that.
Watch your tone. Watch your tone.
That was amazing.
That was beautiful.
Very nice.
Hey, you got some of that bomb? I want some of
that.
Man, I
ain't
even got that, man. It's a stick up. It's a stick up. Hiccup. Click up.
Otis got you.
It's a click in the matrix.
Where could people reach you, Mr. Poetic?
Well, my email is MrPoetic323@gmail.com. My Twitter is @MrPoetic323. Facebook, Darnell Davenport Jr., my government.
Mm-hmm.
That's your whole name.
Damn, he's giving up the social and everything.
Yeah.
566.
Or you can just, you know, I got videos on YouTube, Mr. Poetic, or just Google Mr. Poetic, and, you know, everything should pop up.
I got a question for you. As far as poetry, when did you know this is what you wanted to do? At what age?
When I got my first sack.
I was 15.
15?
I was 15.
You remember what the first poem was? Or the one that you wrote?
I do. But I don't remember the poem. Mm-hmm. Like, I can't remember it word for word. But I remember what poem it was because I had did it at a talent show. Mm-hmm. And this lady, she just came up to me and she was crying. I'm like, wow. Like, you know, I didn't even know I would even have the ability to read someone like that. Mm-hmm.
Did you get the
and
drugs?
I was only 15.
Oh, never mind.
And, what'd you say?
Did you get the draws?
Oh, no, you know, it was.
Because you got a girl crying that's halfway.
Yeah, I know.
You ain't no real poet. Like,
yeah.
But yeah, that was when, you know, that's when, and everyone always was saying, oh, you know, you're very talented for a young age, you know, and so I just continued, because, you know, before poetry, it was other stuff, you know, like gangbanging and like that was
stick up, bitch. Give me all what you get, bitch. And,
like, that wasn't leading me nowhere. You know what I mean? So it's like.
So you turned to weed.
Well, you know,
nigga, weed compound.
Weed is actually, it gives me inspiration. Like when I'm high, I write. Well, I haven't written a poem in a while, but when I'm high, I write though. And like that poem, actually, I wrote it all in my head. You know, like my poems, I write all of my poems in my head. So it's like when I'm faded, I listen to music, da 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 da, and it write it all. So by that time, I can memorize.
That's a good outlet. That's a good outlet.
The poets ever like freestyle, like, I don't know, rhyme against
freestyle
each other?
Freestyle a poem?
Do they ever do? I'm not asking to, but do people do that sometimes?
Is
that
poetry battle.
Yeah. Slam.
If Matt challenged you right now and y'all just did like a poetry off, like, does that ever happen?
Oh, them niggas look like the number 10 standing next to them.
That would be tough.
Back, you know what? Years ago, they used to.
Really?
They used to, like, just call people out. Actually, I've had someone call me out before.
That could go really bad. Hold on 1 second. We have a caller. Okay. Caller, what's your name and where you're calling from?
Yeah, this is Biff Treadwell from Small Town, USA.
Hey, Biff.
Hello, Biff.
Treadwell.
Hey, I'd like to just say I love your show, and I was listening last week in your segments about guess which race. There's a guy on the end there, TRC or whatever his name is, Huge Shaw. My wife and I were sitting at home watching television, and out of nowhere, car pulls up, and out jumps this huge Negro. All of a sudden, to my astonishment, he shits right on my driveway, right into my car. And then he wipes his ass on the grass. Apparently, he swallows chicken bones. And on behalf of my wife and I like to say, fuck you, you son of a bitch.
Very well.
That's a great fucking call.
Thank you for the call, Middle America.
Small town.
Small town in his ass.
His nickname is Most Defecate. So.
Most Defecate.
He shit last week. He revealed to us he shit on someone's lawn.
Oh,
and he had on toilet paper, so he dragged his ass on the grass. Oh, that rhymes.
That was A-How.
You're a poet and didn't know it.
Crazy.
We have a caller. Caller, what's your name and where you're calling from?
It was great. Hey, it's Nikki from Miami.
Hey Nikki.
I'm loving the Talent Thursdays. I'm a white rapper. I wanted to know what I had to do to get on your show.
Give me some pussy. That's how you got it.
I second that emotion, but I'm first to go.
Just reach around. Reach around.
Does he like white girls? I know he likes them a little bit thick and curvy, but I got an ass.
No, he likes. Do you have a debit card? And if you're white, he loves you.
I do. I got American Express.
Speedy.
Oh, Speedy.
The
one. Speedy.
Wow. I think he might wife you.
So this is what you do.
He'll take you to a FairCon meeting.
Okay. All right, just hit me on Facebook, which is Comedian Speedy, and we'll hook it up for you.
Really, Speedy?
Or you can
baby.
What is that?
She said, can she tweet?
Baby, can I tweet to you?
Yes, you can.
Are you on Twitter right now? What's your Twitter?
My Twitter?
Yeah.
Is that Miami?
Hysterical.
Hilarious. What was that last part? I didn't get that last part. Was it fuck or bitch? What was that? Or shit?
It's both.
What is it again?
And how do I get on that challenge Thursday?
Hit us up. Are you on our Team RAR page?
I'm not.
Ask to join the
I'm
team.
I'm not in Miami. I'm at South Beach right now. I'm laying on the beach. I was watching the show. I love what you guys are doing, but I think I can get on there.
Okay. Well, just go on to ask to join Team RAR, and then we'll accept. And then, or you could just send, you know, Claudia Jordan or Speedy.
The Twitter is Speedy is funny. That's
oh,
Speedy
God,
I-Z
Speedy's
funny.
Trying
Impossible.
To hit.
Oh,
no. You want my arm to fall off?
Don't forget to make a donation to get your t-shirt, too.
All right. Thank you, love. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Have fun on South Beach.
We said, give me some pussy.
In your mouth.
A white rapper. Form. That's original.
Yeah, we're real fun.
That Speedy is funny.
But
Speedy,
yeah, Big Dog, you said that you got out of the gang banging and everything. Because I've worked with Jim Brown a lot, you know, Mayor I Can and stuff like that. So, yeah, man. Spread that, you know what I'm saying? Get the that's what we spread to get the youngsters.
I like that hat. Now, what rhymes with torn ACL?
Oh my God. Bail.
Once again, give your information, man.
Where can we find you? Where can we find you?
The fans? MrPoetic323@gmail.com. Follow me on Twitter at MrPoetic323. Facebook, Darnell Davenport Jr. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Google Mr. Poetic.
All right. Well, thank you for joining us this afternoon. All the best to you guys. We're going to take a quick break. It's Reach Around Radio.
I need some more Bascal.
247-7443.
Reach Around.
Clap your hands and see.